Hello, friends. My name is David Harrison, and I'm an environmental linguist. I study the world's most endangered languages and document the knowledge about the natural world that's found in those languages. What I love about my job is that I get to travel to remote places like islands in the South Pacific and meet with some truly remarkable people. On Futuna Island in Vanuatu, I sat down with this young man. His name is Anselon Seru, and listened with wonder as he was able to name 250 different species of fish. He knows these fish and the marine ecosystem intimately, and he spends many hours out in this wooden canoe, sailing and fishing. And he can also name the names for the 18 different winds that blow in different directions around his island, something called a wind compass, which is a technology that allows him to navigate out of sight of his island and return home safely. I also sat down with this man, his name is Ruben Nariam, over a period of a week, and recorded more than 2,000 plant names that he was able to describe and to talk about their medicinal and healing properties. This is a remarkable body of knowledge. The botanists who were with me on this expedition were astounded because more than half of the plants that Ruben was able to name for us and identify are not yet known to botanical science. They are new to science, yet they are known to local people. This knowledge can only be accessed if we're willing to listen and appreciate what these experts have to tell us in their own native languages. Much of this knowledge cannot be translated into global languages like French or English because of the way it's structured and its intimate connection to the environment. And it is the heritage of thousands of years of human ingenuity and creativity and observation of the natural world. It's not an exaggeration to say that what these people know, what Anselon knows about fish and the marine ecosystem, what Ruben knows about plants, could quite literally save the planet, but only if we're willing to listen to them and to appreciate this knowledge. We have to approach cultures with a sense of curiosity, but also a sense of humility. We don't know everything. We don't even know what it is we don't know. And by listening to the environmental experts, such as people that I'm able to meet in my field studies, we can improve our understanding of sustainability and of biodiversity. It's been my great privilege to travel and work in remote places like Siberia, the Himalayas, the South Pacific. And it's also been a wonderful opportunity to bring students along and colleagues. We've been to places like Oaxaca, Mexico, where we're working with local communities to help them revitalize their languages. One way to revitalize a language is through technology. And at Swarthmore College, I created a platform called the Talking Dictionary. A Talking Dictionary is an online, accessible on smartphone or computer, repository of the knowledge and the words in a language, along with photographs, video clips, explanations. It's often a very first presence for some of these languages on the internet. So it helps them cross the digital divide, creating this first presence, helps preserve their languages, and it fully acknowledges their intellectual property. These languages belong to the communities that speak them. And we, as linguists, are curators of this knowledge. It's been a wonderful collaboration that has included not only me and my students and colleagues going on expeditions to these communities, but also inviting many indigenous experts to the United States to share their knowledge with us. My work is based on reciprocity, it's based on respect, and it's based on a sense of wonder and awe for the knowledge about the natural environment that is found in indigenous cultures. I'm David Harrison, and I'm an environmental linguist.